Servus Freunde, my name is Jimmy Cage. I've reviewed almost 500 indie movies on the channel, and when I realized that it has been more than a year since I did a Bengali film, I decided to watch a Hindi one. Well, at least a Hindi language one. Honestly, I just naively assumed that something by Mrinal Sen must certainly be in Bengali. He's regarded as one of the greatest Indian filmmakers, who gets always mentioned in that legendary quartet of Bengali directors, alongside Ritwik Ghatak, Tapan Sinha and of course Satyajit Ray. With the latter, we are already fairly familiar with, as we have watched and reviewed almost all of Ray's films 2 years ago when we celebrated his centenary. And you know what? This year marks the centenary of Mrinal Sen, so why not watch some of his films? Unfortunately, as opposed to the work of Ray, it's much harder to find Sen's films in decent quality with English subtitles. But at least a few are available, even though I think none in great quality, which is really a shame considering his status in the history of world cinema. Bhuvan Shome, which I will get to in a second, is actually not the first of his films that we covered on the channel. Last year we talked about his 1989 film Ek Din Achanak, which was also in Hindi. Well, at least Bhuvan Shome has some Bengali in it, and Bengali culture plays a significant part as well. And it of course also stars the great Utpal Dutt as the titular character Bhuvan Shome. Bhuvan Shome, the film, not the character, came out in 1969. It's a comedy drama based on a Bengali story by Balai Chand Mukhopadhyay. It is considered a landmark in Indian cinema. It won 3 national film awards: Best Feature Film, Best Actor for Utpal Dutt, and Best Direction for Mrinal Sen. And it is said to have pioneered the Indian New Wave. Going into it, I had no idea what to expect, but it was pretty much love at first sight. Just the presentation of the opening credits alone. How Sen introduces us to this story. How he arranges the fast-moving railway track with this traditional and yet experimental-sounding score that was composed by Vijay Raghava Rao. How the names of everyone involved are passing by before our eyes. How our main character is teased through a freeze frame, then by people talking dismissively about him, then by a voiceover narration done by Amitabh Bachchan, accompanied by a small glimpse of his daily life and the beginning of his journey, which will make the rest of the film. And even a small animated segment that was done by Ram Mohan of Prague. Mrinal Sen's film has such a dynamic, kind of experimental, surreal and almost explosive form that it's a pure delight to watch. It's really entertaining and there's definitely a lot of humor to it, which again I didn't expect at all when I chose this film. Honestly, it's one of those films that totally rekindled my passion for cinema. Don't get me wrong, most of the time I have a pretty good time watching all kinds of movies. But you probably notice yourself, when you watch a lot of movies, there comes a time where you might feel a bit weary of it. But then, every now and then, there comes a movie like Bhuvan Shome. A movie that's already more than 50 years old, that totally catches you by surprise and makes you excited all over again. And that even in this pretty shabby quality that I had to watch the movie in. Bhuvan Shome is just a little bit over 90 minutes long. It's a simple yet profound film at the same time. It's actually quite magical or poetic. It tells the story of an old railway officer, a strict and arrogant man set in his ways. A man from the city who embarks on a journey to the Gujarat countryside for a hunting trip. Though by no means has he any expertise in hunting, much to our enjoyment, I have to say. The film follows him on his trip, as he gets carried around in a small ox cart, how he observes the local women and their customs, how he encounters a seemingly wild buffalo, or how he moves through the thick fields feeling like a real adventurer. And then, somewhere around the halfway point of the movie, he makes the acquaintance with the young local woman Gori, played by Suhasini Mulai in her first role. In the time span of both of their lives, their encounter is pretty brief, and yet it has a profound effect on Bhuvan Shome, who slowly but surely is going through a transformation. Mrinal Sen has created a fun and beautiful film about the human condition, about compassion, friendship and also our place in this world. It's also one of those films that paint a pretty sweet picture about the relation between man or woman and the animal kingdom. It's certainly a low-budget film, and yet it's able to create such wonderful pictures. The cinematography by K.K. Mahajan is really nice, but it's how everything comes together here. Like, in its opening moments, the form can get quite experimental, but it never loses its emotional appeal. And Utpal Dutt, who reminded me a little bit of George C. Scott here, and Suhasini Mulai are just so wonderful together. The form, the presentation can be very striking, and yet the characters and what's going on between them and internally with our main protagonist, it all feels so natural and real. It's a really beautiful film and I'm so happy to have watched it. So in German I'd say, Bhuvan Shome ist ein ganz besonderer Film. Simpel und gleichzeitig nahezu berauschend erzählt, witzig und berührend. Ein zeitloser Klassiker. I give Bhuvan Shome 9 out of 10. It's more like 8.5, but I don't do that. Alright, that's it like always. Comment below and let me know what you think about Bhuvan Shome. And also let me know what is your favorite film by Mrinal Sen. You can hit me up on Twitter, Instagram, Letterboxd and also on Patreon simply at The Jimmy Cage. And if you enjoyed this episode, please give me a thumbs up, share, subscribe, whatever you like. And make sure you hit that bell for all I have to tell.